Well, several Mainers have personal connections to the Kennedy assassination.
Among them, two Portland lawyers. WMTW News 8's Paul Merrill spoke with them today and joins us now live with their stories. Paul.
Well, Tracy and Steve, Severin Beliveau was a member of the Honor Guard stationed at the U.S. Capitol during Kennedy's funeral procession. Harold Patius worked for Sergeant Shriver at the Peace Corps. 50 years ago today, Patius found himself inside the White House for the first time.
So there I was in this room with 8 or 9 people making, I've never been in the White House, making arrangements for the funeral of the president.
Harold Patius was working for the Peace Corps on November 22, 1963. A store clerk told him the president had been shot. Patius went back to his office, and that's where he learned that Kennedy had died.
30 seconds later, the flag on the roof of the White House went down to half-mast. It was a chilling thing.
Patius found himself inside the White House because he was lending a black tie to his boss, Kennedy brother-in-law Sergeant Shriver. For 90 minutes, Patius sat silently listening to the funeral planning. He remembers a debate over whether foreign dignitaries would be allowed to walk behind Kennedy's casket.
Shriver said, "I'll never forget this." He said, "No, we can't do that. We can't have these people, these chiefs of state, all out walking on 17th Street. If they can get Jack the way they did today, they can get Buffalo Bill walking down the street."
The heads of state did end up walking in the funeral procession. One of the Honor Guard members at the U.S. Capitol that day, Severin Beliveau.
We were told to keep our eyes straight ahead, and of course, none of us did. We all watched as the family followed the casket. There wasn't a dry eye on the stairway.
Beliveau had been just feet from the president during Kennedy's inauguration.
"Ask not what your country can do for you. Ask what you can do for your country."
Barely 3 years later, he found himself standing guard as hundreds of thousands of mourners passed by the president's casket.
The effect it had on everyone was palpable. I mean, to say we were sad was an understatement. But here we were, a very innocent country. We felt for the first time that we were vulnerable, that the most powerful person in the world had been shot, killed. We felt violated, I suppose, and that was a feeling that all these people felt.
One thing we did not expect today was to run into a Mainer who was in Dallas 50 years ago today, but we did. Hear his story tonight at 6. Live in the studio, Paul Merrill, WMTW News 8.